And it's not like it's set aside over here and y'all can't get, no. They, as long as they're going to worship under the Levitical priesthood, they can't drop that and come over here and worship with us at our altar. And our altar is not a spatial place. It's in the heart. We worship wherever we are. Doesn't matter. And we don't look toward Mecca nor Jerusalem or nowhere else. So we have an altar where those who serve the tabernacle, they don't know anything about this. But you can see this in Christian history as it unfolds, and some of these priests became believers. But they don't know what that means right off, but they're going to find out that their job description is no good anymore. Not just in the kingdom of God, even in the kingdom of this world, because the city of Jerusalem was destroyed, the temple, the place of worship was destroyed, and now even the Jews have to find some other place to worship. So they go back to synagogue worship, but the Christians, they don't go to synagogue worship. The Gentile Christians, they go out and they worship in the homes and wherever they are. You understand? And that's how it all began. Now, listen to Jesus. Jesus in the flesh cannot say, we and us. He cannot say that. He can only say, me and you. Now, you, some are catching it. Jesus is unique, folks. He is the only soul that ever walked the face of the earth that was begotten of God in the womb. Adam was created by God. Jesus was begotten of God. And in the days of his humiliation, or in the days of his flesh, which are the four gospel accounts, or better, the historical Jesus, he cannot say we unless he's talking about him and God, because they're the only ones. And he tells about this. I have a witness that's greater than John. My Father witnesses to it. The Spirit of God witnesses to it. You see, so when he was born of the flesh, the historical Jesus, he was begotten of God. That's unique, never happened before, and never happened again. That's it. So he is so alone in this world, he can't say we. But on resurrection day, he becomes the first begotten from the dead. First, the others begotten from the dead. Now, he is the first fruits of them that slept. He now can say, we and us. You understand? Yeah. And so now, after the resurrection, Jesus can speak in terms like that. And Peter, Paul, James, and John, his spokesmen, do speak like that. But it's not until Paul that it brings in an uncircumcised pagan. And then the question's going to be, well, what is going to be the lifestyle? What's going to be the religion of these Christian pagans? It can't be Judaism, because if it's Judaism, they'll have to be circumcised and then become a part of the we and us in circumcision. And so Paul says, well, look, there's no difference in the family of God. That there's no such thing as circumcision or uncircumcision in the family of God, because they're all the spiritual children of God. And regeneration wipes out anything in the flesh. Circumcision is in the flesh. The flesh, it's the spirit that's regenerated and enters the kingdom of God. It's not the flesh. So you can't bring circumcision into the kingdom of God, because it's of the flesh. You can only bring spiritual circumcision in. And then you go back, and that's what God is telling them all the time. I have no respect for your physical circumcision because I don't see your heart circumcised. You want me to respect you? Circumcise your heart. Now, folks, it's the same thing for the Christian. We can't run around saying, we're under grace and God doesn't any longer see the things we do. He only sees the blood of his crucified son. Yes, that's all he sees when it comes to salvation, to the transaction of taking you out of Adam and putting you into Christ. But as the children of God, we are to sanctify ourselves, set ourselves apart to be the children of God, walking in faith and love so that God can see the reflection of the image that he put in us. Because the image comes in at birth, but the likeness comes by behavior, and we're in control of that. We're in control of the behavior, so that should be the likeness of God. And so, as the book of Hebrews closes out, we need to understand who this book is talking to and what it's talking about. Then when we get to the end, we can understand that the altar for the second covenant people is not physical, earthly, or seen. That all of that is seen goes with the first covenant, but in the second covenant, it is unseen. And so Paul says that the invisible things of God from the very creation of time are clearly seen, Romans 1:21, being clearly understood by what? By the things that are made. And so these visible things are taken to be pictures and shadows of types of something spiritual in the eternal kingdom of God. And so, let's continue to sing, and let's place ourselves in the context. On which side of the Red Sea are we? Are we redeemed? Then we can sing about redemption, you see. Otherwise, we're standing on the outside looking in. And you notice that the number one thing that's common in all of these testimonies of salvation, one thing they all have in common: peace with God. You see how spiritual that is? Not peace on earth, but peace with God. And so, John, come on and let's continue and welcome all of you that are with us for the first time. And we have an open forum. You know, you're welcome to come. But we do, sometimes people request that somebody does something. I try to not to request too much, but I do have a request, John. I don't have to request that you sing. I think that maybe somebody else will take care of that, although you haven't yet done so. Get that medley going for me. But John, I need to hear from you. We're hearing from these other folks here. And I know John is always in the Word, and he's coming up with stuff. I mean, him and Tim and many of you just bless me by asking me questions that I don't know the answer to. And I understand from Jack, is this right? John has really been loading the wagon down there. Okay. We need a report on that. Okay. Just ever how brief you want to make it or whatever, John, but if you want to turn me down, okay, but